In this video, we're going to talk about the examples of biomolecules, specifically the four types: carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. These are macromolecules, which means they are very large molecules containing thousands of covalently bonded atoms. Carbohydrates, proteins, and nucleic acids, they are biopolymers, which are made out of smaller building blocks called monomers. Starting with carbohydrates, it's made up of monosaccharides as the building blocks. Carbohydrate can be classified as monosaccharides. Monosaccharides are made out of different number of carbons, and the common ones are made up of six carbons like glucose, fructose, and galactose. Disaccharide refers to two. So disaccharide means it's made out of two monosaccharides joined together via a carbon-oxygen-carbon bond, which is called glycosidic linkage. Some examples of disaccharides are sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Polysaccharide, as the name suggests, involves many monosaccharides joined together. The one that we're familiar with are starch, cellulose, and glycogen. They're all made out of glucose units. The only difference between them is how the glucose units are joined. Notice the difference in the patterns? Starch consists of millions of amylopectin and amylose molecules. The function of carbohydrates include providing us with energy. Bread, pasta, potatoes, oats, these are all food sources of carbohydrates that gives us energy. Glucose energy is stored as glycogen in animals and starch in plants for later use. It's also used to build other macromolecules like ribose and deoxyribose, which are the building blocks for RNA, DNA, and ATP. We'll talk about it later. When all these energy, glycogen storing capacity, and building needs of the body are met, excess glucose will then be used to make fat. This is something to take note of for people who eat a lot of carbohydrates or sweet stuff. So if you're on a low-fat diet and you're wondering why you're still gaining weight, chances are high it's because of these excess carbs. Next are the proteins, which are made of lots of amino acids. There are 20 types altogether, but if you add up the two amino acids that are made during translational process, then we do have 22 types altogether. All these amino acids are basically the same except for the R group. They all have the amino group and the carboxyl group, and the only thing that is different, that makes them different from one another, is this side chain, which we're going to refer to as the R group. So depending on what's connected in that R group, that makes the amino acid different from one another. Proteins are classified as primary structure, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. In a primary structure, all the amino acids are linked together through a peptide bond, which is basically an amide bond. They form a long polypeptide chain. So that essentially is the primary structure. When the backbone of the polypeptide chain interacts with one another, meaning we're talking about the atoms that are not part of the side chain, when those atoms interact with one another within the same polypeptide chain, then we get a secondary structure. And they have two types of shape. One is alpha helix and the other one is beta pleated sheet. And when the R groups of the amino acids interact with each other, then we get an overall 3D structure. That's the tertiary structure. So the difference between secondary and tertiary structure lies in the type of atoms that interacted with each other in the polypeptide chain. An example of the R group interaction is the disulfide bonds. Take our hair for example. The protein that's present in our hair is called keratin, and the alpha helices in our hair are coiled by hydrogen bonding, that's the secondary structure, and disulfide bonds, that's the tertiary structure. And then we have some proteins that are made out of several polypeptide chains, which we normally call them as subunits. So when two or more subunits get together, we then get something called a quaternary structure. Protein has many roles in our body. They make up the structural components of our cells and tissues, allowing metabolic reaction to take place and coordinate bodily functions. We move on to the third biopolymer, which are the nucleic acids. It's made out of many nucleotides. Other monomers, it consists of three components: pentose sugar, which is connected to a nitrogen-containing base, and also a phosphate. There are two types of nucleic acid. One is DNA and the other one is RNA. There are several differences between DNA and RNA. One of them is in their structure. DNA has a double helix, while RNA is single-stranded. Another difference is in their nitrogen-containing base. DNA has AGC, same with RNA. However, DNA has tyrosine, whereas in RNA, it has uracil. They are also different in their function. DNA is responsible for the storage of genetic information, whereas RNA is responsible for the expression of the genetic information. The fourth biomolecule are lipids. There are many types of lipids, and the most common ones are triglycerides, or more commonly known as fats and oils, and they are made out of glycerol and fatty acids. The glycerol and fatty acids get together through ester linkages to form triglycerides. As the name suggests, tri refers to three, and that's why we have three fatty acids in the structure. We can classify triglycerides as saturated, monounsaturated, or polyunsaturated, depending on the type of fatty acids that are present in the structure. So generally, triglycerides serve as energy storage and insulation to keep us warm as well as protect our organs. Another example of lipids are steroids, which consists of four rings combined together. They're important components of cell membranes and signaling molecules. Phospholipids are rather similar to triglycerides, except for it has a phosphate group with amino alcohol instead of having three fatty acids connected to the glycerol. It's a key component for cell membranes. Waxes are esters made out of long chain alcohol and fatty acids. They provide protection, especially to plants to protect the leaves. In humans, we have ear wax to help protect the skin of the ear canal. That's how wax functions as a protection or insulation. I've put together a mind map covering all these four biomolecules. Click on the link below to download your copy. Do give this video a thumbs up if you found value in it. Don't forget to subscribe for more chemistry videos like this. I'll see you in the next one.